Is the work world confusing? Congested? Are you just trying to find your way? There must be a light at the end of this tunnel. Well, there's a way to find your calling, to find that job you want and deserve, when someone will come up to you and say, "You're hired." Hi, I'm Steve Piazzale, a career and life coach, and welcome to Your Hired, a show about jobs and careers in which we answer questions such as, how do I find work that makes me come alive? How do I get that job I want and deserve? How do I find out about careers in different fields? We're going to answer these questions and others by having on the show knowledgeable, lively guests, and we certainly have one today. Before I introduce him, though, I'd like to invite you to check out my website, where you'll find the 12 keys to getting a great job, sign up for my free career newsletter, watch on demand some previous episodes of the show, and find out about the career coaching I do. Essentially, what I do is work with people one-on-one to help them get unstuck and build momentum towards achieving their goals more quickly than they would on their own. This usually ends up saving them time, money, and a whole lot of stress, and we land them in a job that's a better fit than they'd find on their own. You can find out about all this and much more at www.BayAreaCareerCoach.com. That's www.BayAreaCareerCoach.com. Well, I want to welcome Seymour Duncker to the show. Seymour is founder and CEO of iCharts and author of the new book Lean Startup Tweet, 140 Insights for Building a Lean Startup. And that's what he's here to talk to us about, lean startups. Welcome, Seymour.
Steve, nice having
Yeah, welcome to the show. So why don't you tell us about this company you founded? I'm very fascinated by this.
Thank you, Steve. Well, our vision at iCharts is to empower the world to share and explore visual data. Visual data like in charts. Mm-hmm. A couple of years ago, I came across this incredibly huge figure of 900 billion charts that could print it every year.
Oh my.
That will eventually move online. And we want to be the company that moves those online and enable sharing and exploring of that data. What we do is we provide an online solution for visual interactive reporting for the $36 billion market research industry. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And we serve Fortune 500 companies and the market research vendors that serve them. That's what we do.
And it's interactive of some sort, right? When I saw the demo that
Absolutely. So all our charts and visuals that we bring online are automatically interactive. You can, the when you come on the website, you can drill, you can zoom into the data, you can switch your views, you can re-embed them as you like.
And is there a way to do any kind of commentary or voiceover, like you're sending the chart to someone and asking them about, or saying this is the data for blah, blah, blah? Or
absolutely. So you can put audio comments with the charts. You can put comments into the chart. You can allow the charts to be re-embedded onto a different site so that they can travel and they can, when you want to write a data story and you have an interesting visual, let's combine that and create an interesting story about that.
So, you know, your new book is about lean startups. So tell us what a lean startup is and maybe give us a little bit of your history in forming the company, because I think it's always interesting for people watching, thinking you didn't just weren't born with this idea, but you came to it. So
kind of
both those questions, like how you came to form the company, what was the path, and what is a lean startup?
Right. Well, so I would say the traditional term is bootstrap. You know, you're bootstrapping your company, which means you're trying to achieve a goal with the minimal resources. You're trying to achieve something to build something, right? Now, a lean startup is a mindset, right? As compared to bootstrapping. Bootstrapping, having minimal resources, trying to build something is a function. However, having a lean startup, or you know, doing something the lean way, is having a mindset, being agile, about the way you go and about the way you do it. Consider a leopard. A leopard cannot afford a single gram of fat, whether be it young or old, right? So that's you know, that's the mind of, you know, the thinking you need to have when you build a company these days, my opinion, right? Mm-hmm. You know, pretty much if you consider, just to give you a graphical example, like series like, you know, Prison Break or 2024, they have the concept they're based on. You have a small team that has an incredible challenge they need to achieve in an incredible short time. They have limited resources achieve that, and you know, stones get thrown into the way all the time. Yeah. And you know, they're running out of time all the time, right? So and they have to be very creative about how to, you know, achieve their end goal. They have to be perfectionist about what they do. They have to be agile about that. Mm-hmm. That's pretty much what a lean startup is.
Was this a hard transition for you to get in that mindset, or did it come naturally based on your background?
Well, my background, I started this company actually back in Europe, and I moved to the US. I had this idea, I'm going to build this company, and I will do that in the US. I started in the Europe, I formed the company in the US, and I moved then to the US last year. So, I think I always have been in a mode where I had to be like, in a short time frame, had to deliver things. So I think it comes pretty much natural to the way I think, mm-hmm. right? I don't think it's like, a big thing, right? Mm-hmm. I just think you have to be constantly at it. You have to be...
You're leading right into the next question I was going to ask you, is tips you'd have for somebody else that's thinking, maybe they have a different business idea and they think, geez, I'd like to start something up, but I don't know if I have the money, I don't know. What are some of the tips you would give to somebody who's thinking of doing what you've done?
Well, I mean, I have a lot of things which I've put into the book, but I think the one thing that I really would pick from that is you need to be extremely passionate about what you do, right? Passionate and persistent, right? I think those two things, that for me, that those are the fundamentals, right? If you're not extremely passionate, then you won't have the breath that it takes to get from here to there, right? Mm-hmm. It's easy to be passionate about for one day or for a week. I mean, that's called excitement. But mm-hmm. being passionate about it over a long period of time, like a year, 2 years, 3 years, you have to bring people into it, right? That's the persistent, the persistent part about it. You need to, you need to be. That's what I definitely would, say that's what you want to have.
I may throw you for a loop here, but how do you find your passion? I have so many clients that ask me that. How do I find what I'm passionate about? I mean, is it the specific business idea of these charts, or could it have been many other things and it's just the idea of building a business and providing a service for somebody? But can you talk just a little more about passion, or sure. how you found it, or what it could be defined by?
Sure. So what you do that's building a business, right? But I think what it fundamentally boils down to is why you're doing it. What is your motivation? What is your drive? Fundamentally, that's what it is about. So you have this dream, you have this idea which you want to, which you really truly absolutely believe in. That's what's driving you. That's what you get passionate about. Then obviously, you have to do something out of it, right? Some people drive adoption, and it's about how many people, how many users use what you create. Mm. Others create businesses around that that make, profitable in a short time frame, right? So that's a function of it, but ultimately, doing what, believing in that, what you're doing, and bringing that to market, that's what's driving your passion.